Such a sad morning here in Newtown, Connecticut. I'm joined by Elizabeth Vargas in New York. And right behind me, the Sandy Hook Firehouse, where moms and dads came to learn about their children, many sleeping here through the night. And this headline from the Hartford Courant right here says it all. Our hearts are broken. Speaking for so many Americans today, over 20 little children dead, more adults died after the worst shooting ever at a grade school. Here is what we know right now. The shooter, Adam Lanza, was 20 years old. He also shot his mother before coming to the school. The bodies of the children slain are still in the school, and families were notified overnight. The names of the victims will be released this morning. Look, you're going to look now at stills from the vigil right here in Sandy Hook last night, a scene of so much unimaginable grief. There they are right there, the families, the community coming together to pray for their children, those who were lost, to remember them, to try and comprehend what happened here in Newtown, Connecticut. My GMA Weekend colleague Dan Harris has been here right from the very beginning covering this tragedy, and you watched it unfold through the day yesterday.
We did. George, you know, just when you thought these mass shootings, which you and I have covered way too many of, just when you thought they couldn't get worse or more shocking, along comes Adam Lanza, who began his day by killing his mother and ended it by storming that school. And of all the people he shot, there was only one survivor.
9:40 a.m. Reports of gunfire at Sandy Hook Elementary.
Sandy Hook School. Callers indicating she thinks there's someone shooting in the building.
Police say 20-year-old Adam Lanza, seen here as a teenager, wore a bulletproof vest and was carrying at least three semi-automatic weapons, including a rifle.
Everybody was a little scared, crying, and I felt actually a little sick.
Within 5 to 10 minutes, the first SWAT teams arrived.
Yeah, these units in the pool, I got bodies here.
Officers helped teachers lead several hundred students to a nearby fire station.
When the policeman came in to get us, he told us to close our eyes and, like on the picture on the news, do this and run.
At 10:30 a.m., President Obama was briefed on the situation while police discovered a second crime scene. The shooter's mother, Nancy Lanza, who authorities believe may have worked at Sandy Hook at some point, was found dead. Police say Adam Lanza shot her before he stormed the school. Around noon, ABC News learned that Lanza had killed 27 people, most of them children, before turning the gun on himself. Shortly after 3, the president addressed the nation.
I know there's not a parent in America who doesn't feel the same overwhelming grief that I do. The majority of those who died today were children. Beautiful little kids between the ages of 5 and 10 years old.
By 7 p.m., this little town had settled into an all too familiar post-massacre routine with prayer vigils.
May God bless our children who are with us today and those who were taken away. May God bless the adults who lost their lives today.
Overnight, police engaged in the horrifying work of identifying the bodies and then notifying the families. Now the big question in this investigation is why? What was the suspect's motive? George, if past is prologue, we may get an answer, but it will be deeply unsatisfying.
It certainly will. Okay, Dan, thanks very much.